What's good, YouTube family, man? This your God Bless One. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. So apparently, the feds have picked up FBG Duck case right quick. You know what I'm saying? And I'm mad that they didn't been picked up on it. Shout out to Mama Duck, first of all. Y'all look for the links in the description box. Go subscribe to Mama Duck Slayer, Clout Chaser, Clout Slayer TV. Go in the links in the description box and you can rock out with it, and I got y'all. But do me a favor and hit that like button right quick. Hit that notification bell and rock out with me. Make sure you hit the subscribe and you hit that bell next to it and you click on all. That's the notifications, y'all. Now, the feds picked up on the FBG Duck case situation. And if you had any part with that great rapper that he was, great man that he was, bruh, it's, you gone, folks. When feds want to actually do the homework and do the work, bruh, you know it's time up for you, gang. Niggas gonna be flipping on each other like it ain't nothing. So everything look cool in the motion, right? But watch how many people starts getting caught like flies out here, bro. I ain't even capping, bro. I'm going to sit back and watch. Everybody that was laughing don't know how to do their scores and do it the right way. And shh. But in this case, I like FBG Duck a whole lot, bro. In this case, I'm actually, I don't wish jail or prison on no man, but I'm happy something is being done because it seemed like it was only always one-sided. Whether do the politicians picking sides with this gang shit, you know what I'm saying, bro? Like, it was some fuck shit going around with the FBG Duck case, bro. All the way to Mayor Lori Lightfoot, she ain't did shit to get justice for Duck, talking about he's a gangster and all that. In other words, she basically made a press conference basically like celebrating FBG Duck's death. You know what I mean? That was cold, bro. She was celebrating it, enjoying it. And I'm thinking, bro, if this was Garth Brooks, right? If this was Britney Spears, Justin Timberlake, do you think they'll let a case sit past a month like that without getting some type of suspects or names? And I ain't talking about Instagram situations where folks is just tweaking out here. You know what I'm saying, man? That was always wild to me. How the hell FBG Duck ain't getting the justice he deserved? But you know what? It's better now than later, because a lot of these rappers die and it be 10 whole years later, you don't see no type of justice for them. So in this particular situation, as my bro, I swear to God, some of my neighbors are nosy as hell. Like, they never seen somebody with a camera, folks. Like, these folks so nosy, bro. You be having a camera out here, they be staring at you, bro. Like, what am I doing today, bro? I know I'm in an affluent neighborhood, but damn. Back to this, bro. Now, with FBG Duck situation, bro, you fall back and you think for a little bit. You go, what's the chess move here, bro? Like, his name rung bells. Like, if you're one of the lames who say you don't know who Duck is, you don't rock with FBG Duck, cool. But if you're from that Midwest area, but especially specifically in Illinois, he's ringing names everywhere for the last decade and some change, and then some. So you're talking about 10 plus years, bro, in this game, and the news don't even really go full throttle on this case. They talk more about the Gold Coast area where he got killed in, because it's a tourist attraction. I feel like if he were to get killed in any other place, they wouldn't even really mention it in the news at all. So whether you think Duck is an underground rapper at all, he's a phenomenal rapper, but I'm not going to get into this by giving him too much praise. I'm going to do it more as, because y'all going to say I'm being biased. I'm going to say, look at his work. Duck is more than an underground rapper. He's an actual rapper from that city, from that state. And moves are not being made to get justice for him, bro. This is why I say I don't wish prison and jail on no man. I wish for street justice. I really believe in street justice. You know what I mean? Street justice will solve anything. Street justice, oh yeah, it'll solve anything, baby. I ain't gonna even lie to you like that. So when you look at the Pop Smoke situation, Corey Walker, you know what I'm saying? They already took the death penalty off the table for that, folks. And I doubt it they even give him life because of his age. And they're going to say he had adults around him. And even if they do give him life, I believe an eye for an eye, bro. It's just me, bro. Like, you take one of my folks and you still up in that facility, I don't care if you rotting in there, educational purpose. I believe the same equations of things should happen to you and transpire in your life, even worse than what it happened to my loved one. So with Duck's situation, karma is best suited for those who are smart enough to play it cool and keep it cool. So if you was dumb enough to put yourself in a situation to get caught up with that FBG Duck situation, that's on you, gang. I ain't gonna feel sorry for you, bro, because you move in a dumbass way. And shout out to Mama Duck, man. She been relentless fighting everybody educational purpose for the support of her son, bruh. That's a mother that goes hard in the paint for her baby boy, bruh. Rest in peace to Brick and her other kids as well, bruh. But to see Duck, you know what I'm saying, finally getting some type of justice, it does make me feel good. But at the same time, I'm like, why does it take all that type of fight to get justice for anybody? I don't care what their background is, what type of thug you think they are, this and that. Why that should let people get away with doing something wrong to any human being? Because y'all preach all this, you know what I'm saying, societal, we got to be civil to each other, but yet you guys only mean it for certain people. Am I right? You only mean civility for those who you count as people or human beings. Like I said, if this was Garth Brooks, you would have never seen this situation take so long. You would have never seen an aim like that. I mean, the world would have been shaking and crying for justice. But hip-hop, another thing with hip-hop people, bruh, I'm gonna be so honest and real, bruh. A lot of hip-hop fans are so fake, and I don't care what your ethnicity is. Hip-hop are fake supporters, bruh. They will cry crocodile tears for you when you surpass and gone. They will make it look like they dying out here without you. But the truth is, they move on to the next rapper, which ain't nothing wrong with that. But they move to the next rapper and act like you didn't even exist out here. Now, that is a problem. It's one thing to be like, you find your new favorite rapper. Cool. You know what I mean? Everybody got their own taste and preference. But what was that whole support of this other rapper for? Like I'm saying, only in this genre of music that it comes and goes. I mean, I'm not going to be fake and say hip-hop is dead. Hip-hop is living forever, bro. Even drill ain't dead, bro. You people tweaking. Drill all over the world, bro. Like, and Duck is the face of it. Drill is all over the world, gang. So when I look at hip-hop, how it is and what it brings, forget about the violent part, the money, the entertainment part, satisfying those of us who go through mental situations or depression or anything like that. It helps us feel good or whatever. So what do we do to give back to hip-hop? I'm asking everybody, besides stealing music online, downloading, because it's crazy, bro. It's like, if I give my kids an option to be a pop singer or a rapper, even though I love hip-hop to my heart to the day I die, I think I'll pick, you know what I'm saying, pop music, only on the basis of they live longer. That's a fact. Motherfuckers is living longer in that type of music. And the fans, they stay with you even when you 50, 60, 70 years old. They rock out with you, bruh. They right there on every show selling out concerts. And our fans in this type of music, bruh, these folks don't rock with us, bruh. They rock with the moment and the trend that you bring in the world. Other than that, these folks don't rock with you, bro. And a lot of rappers can't differentiate. I got a brand new teeth here, y'all. I need to replace this thing because it's broken too. So a lot of the words I pronounce, I apologize. My pronunciation is way off right now, and it is what it is. But with Duck, man, I'm just happy he getting some type of justice. I'll forget all that rant I'm doing. I hope hip-hop people do wake up, but we know it ain't gonna happen. But in this case, at least the side note is that my dog Duck is about to get some type of justice out here. If you guys, to those of you guys who do believe in some type of justice, you know what I mean? So Duck and Mama Duck and Brick and everybody and Kobe and everybody who we lost, not just that side, any side, even King Von and them, I hope all you folks out there in the world, you know, get some type of closure for y'all loved ones, because it's easy to preach, but motherfuckers do need closure out here. Look, I'm your God Bless one. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. God bless the dead. Rest in peace to everybody out there. Salute. I'm gonna stop right now. I just thought about something. I gotta stop right now.
I'm looking at the time. I'm about to just download a whole lot of old videos too, right quick.